Every Monday on the show, we try to ask the question, what's for dinner? And we always give you a heart-healthy alternative. But today, we're just going to talk straight about dessert. Why not? We're giving you such great dinner recipes. Let's talk a little bit about dessert. Michel Bieri from Bay Gourmet is joining us. And what are you making this morning? I can't even pronounce it.
We're going to make a Negresco cake. It's a traditional French chocolate cake from the French Riviera. And it's extremely simple to make, actually. We have a base of Genoise cake that we're going to put simple syrup on it. Earlier, we did some chocolate brushing on the bottom of it, and then it's just Frangelico and simple syrup. We make sure we put plenty of them. And then what we'll do is we'll mix a base of chocolate that we have melted. It's better to use some high-quality chocolate with a lot of cocoa butter.
Do you have some favorites?
Much better.
What are your favorite chocolates?
Well, this one is, it's called Calbo. It comes from France. Just for
shocking.
And then what you do is you kind of mix them, both of them together, whipping cream that you have whipped,
uh-huh.
And you don't have to worry too much. You just put it all together and fold them.
Can I get a full of that?
Yeah, you can try. And then what you do is you kind of just fold it in, fold the chocolate into the whipping cream, and you don't have to worry too much. Usually it's kind of cool outside, but it should be just fine.
Yeah, it's
mixing the
really
cold
good.
And the So it's kind of rich. There is a ratio of about 60% chocolate and 40% whipping cream.
Mm-hmm.
But then it comes to a very smooth thing. And then when we get it right there, what we'll do is we'll don't be bashful and put quite
yes.
a lot of it.
Don't be shy.
That's right. In fact, for the beginning.
Do you have a sweet tooth, Michelle?
Oh.
Yeah.
That's my favorite thing is chocolate. I love chocolate. That's for sure. So you make sure that it goes clear on the edge. So, because when you're going to remove the ring,
mm-hmm.
this is a secret right there, really. And so we'll add a little bit more in the middle. So as you can see, it's fairly rich.
You think?
Then we'll take the second layer of chocolate cake
yeah.
right there in the middle. You make sure you don't touch the edge because the chocolate's going to be the look, the cream, that is. And then,
what exactly is this doing? Is it helping adhere?
You mean the syrup on
mm-hmm.
it? It's just to give it flavor.
Oh.
I mean, you can go pretty wild on the alcohol. I've done it with cognac. I've done it with pear liqueur or Grand Marnier, Cointreau, any orange. And then what we'll do now is
top it off.
Top it off. And
like
you make sure there's plenty of it. And then we'll take a spatula. And then all we do is make it smooth
uh-huh.
on the edge like that. We'll remove some, a little bit too much.
You want me to go over and take a little bit of the too much? So like all of our recipes, you can get it online at KCRA.com or KCRA.com/morningnews, where they'll have all our recipes.
And voila, we got it.
So,
on the screen.
So how long does it set like that?
So, now you've got the best ways to put it in the freezer. Those circles mm-hmm. are really a new way of doing pastry nowadays, because this way you don't have to hold it in your hand. You can smooth it out when you remove and warm the circle with the torch right there. It make it easier to remove. So we've got one already frozen right here.
Okay.
That we're gonna turn on.
Oh, now it's getting hot.
Now we're getting some tools out.
Well.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
So what we'll do right now is we just kind of heated up the side of the cake.
Okay.
To remove it off the side as they come.
30 seconds now.
Okay. Oh. We're almost
Big
there.
Finish. Yes.
Well, I want to see the end of this.
Then usually it comes. Look at that.
That's
so you get the cake off. It's somewhat in the center.
Uh-huh.
You can eat it up just a little bit, even with the torch, to smooth the edge. And then.
And as you do that, I'll remind you, that's it for us on the KCRA3 Reports. We'll have more at noon from the experience. And we're always on at KCRA.com. We'll see you tomorrow starting at 7. Michelle, that was beautiful. Like a flower bending.